Hi, you guys. It's Yaz. And today I'm going to talk about the 10 sneaky ways a narcissist tricks you. And if you're not up on narcissism, you could fall prey to the narcissist because you don't see what they're doing. See, this is the biggest, revelation that people have at the end, is that they feel like the narcissist is like them, and they're not. Narcissists are very sneaky. So I'm going to go into 10 ways that the narcissist tricks you, okay? Number one, and the biggest one that everybody pretty much knows, is they flatter you. Here's the love bombing. They make you think that they're so into you. And how do they do that? By giving you a lot of attention and a lot of their time. As a matter of fact, there's a lot of toxic coaches out there, relationship coaches, that actually teach this to narcissists, teaching them how to trick you into thinking that they really like you when they really don't, okay? And scammers do this as well. Scammers learn from other scammers how to scam. So one of the tricks is to flatter you, give you a lot of attention, build up your head, build up that fantasy in your mind. That's all the love bombing. You're saying, oh, wow, this person is too good to be true. Why is that? Because they are too good to be true, okay? Because as we would say, nobody's that nice in the beginning, okay, when they don't really know you. Somebody could be infatuated with you, all right? That's the difference. Somebody could be infatuated with you, and narcissists can be infatuated with people and build them up in their minds thinking that they're something bigger than they are. And then when they realize and they get to know the person, all of a sudden the narcissist realizes, hey, this person isn't as great as I thought. I think I'm just going to throw them to the wind, okay? Because narcissists, if they're not calculated for a money type of supply, see, there's two types of ways narcissists go about it. You have the narcissist that's calculated from the get-go, that saw you had resources, saw you had benefits, maybe saw you had money, and they calculated how to get that money. And then you have the narcissist who may be lusting you, building you up as a fantasy in their minds. And, when they realize that you're not going to make them happy or they get bored with you, then they throw you to the wind. So the bottom line is, the ways that a narcissist tricks you is to flatter you, be very nice, be very charming, give you plenty of attention, okay? What's another way that a narcissist tricks you? They future fake you, okay? Now, what does that mean exactly, future fake? Well, first, the narcissist is going to mirror you. They're going to pretend that they're just like you. And some of them will actually say things like, oh, we have a lot in common, don't we? Or, we have a good connection, or we're coming from the same place. So they future fake you by talking about whatever you're into. So the more you tell the narcissist, the more you're giving them information about yourself in order for them to manipulate you. So if you tell them, for example, you're a very religious person, you go to church or you go to synagogue or you go to mosque every week or something like that, they are going to mirror that and pretend like, oh, so am I. I do that too. Or I prayed to God that you would come into my life. Or let's pray together. Let's pray together, okay? This is how low down and dirty a narcissist can be that's after something. So the way that they trick you is to mirror you and make you think that they're into the same things that you're into. Now, once they get a feel for who you are, because the narcissist is studying you in the beginning, now they're going to future fake. Now they're going to talk about whatever your fantasy is. Maybe you want to get married. You want to live in a big house. You want to have kids. You want to build a business. That narcissist is going to talk about all the things that are your dreams, okay? They're going to talk about, oh, yeah, we could get married. Maybe we'll be married in a year from now. Wouldn't that be great? And show you pictures of houses. Oh, we could live here. Or talk about what your kids will look like. anybody that sits there and talks about what your kids will look like is a flat-out con artist. Flat-out con artist, because normal people don't do that, all right? Not unless you've known the person a while, maybe you're at the point of engagement, or you're already married. But if somebody's talking about that from the very beginning, you're dealing with a basic bullshitter that's trying to build that fantasy in your mind. They're going to talk about kids. Maybe you're dying to have a family or something like that. They're going to talk about all the things that you are yearning for. And if you're, you know, a vulnerable person that's yearning for these kind of things to make you happy, the narcissist is going to play upon those things that you're yearning for. And you're going to think that you have met, you know, your soulmate. The matter of fact, they'll even sit there and say, oh, you know, you're my soulmate, or I love you unconditionally. Anybody who tells you I love you unconditionally in the very beginning is, again, a con artist. Flat out game. That is flat out game, you guys, all right? Normal relationships, people don't talk like that, okay? Maybe if you've known somebody for, you know, 10 years or something like that, or you've been married, you went through a lot together, then you might say, yeah, I love you unconditionally because I've been through everything with you. But how can you love somebody unconditionally when you don't even know them? You can't. So you got to look at the timing of things. So this is another way that they trick you, is with the future faking. So they flatter you. They give you a lot of attention. They blow up your phone. Yes, they do. They will have you on the phone for hours. Matter of fact, they're going to keep you up at night where you can't even get sleep. They want to keep you on the phone and make you think that they're so into you. This is all to fool you, okay? This usually happens for the first month, maybe, if you get that far. It depends on what they're after. Understand? A narcissist who's after something big is really going to be the best love bomber, okay? They're really going to be the ones that lay it on thick because they know they've got to work for that prize at the end of the rainbow, right? So they're going to flatter you, give you a lot of attention, blow up your phone, text you like crazy, send you constant, you know, kissy emojis and all of that. And what's another way that a narcissist tricks you? They make promises that they don't keep, okay? Ooh, is this a big one, all right? Nobody tricks you more than a narcissist who promises things like, oh, we're going to take vacation on the south of France, or we're going to take vacation to the Caribbean, or, you know, I'm going to help you raise your children, or I'm going to help you paint your house, or I'm going to help you with this. They make constant promises to do things for you, to help you, to be there for you. And the bottom line is, as soon as they realize that they're not getting that supply, or maybe they got the supply, forget it. They never follow through on the promises. That's your covert narcissist, by the way, okay? Or they promise that they're going to see you all the time and they don't, okay? There's constant excuses. So one of the ways that they trick you is building these false promises in your mind that they are going to be there, be your hero, be your savior, have your back, do wonderful things with you. You know, they are your ride or die. This is how they trick you because they have no intentions on following through with these promises, but they tell you what you want to hear. That's why I tell you guys, stop believing words. Where's my plaque? I'm going to put my plaque on the wall that says, stop believing words of what somebody tells you unless you know that person a long time and know that their word means something. Because narcissists lie all the time. This is how they trick you, by lying, flattering you, attention, you know, future faking, making promises. And the other way they trick you is they fake agree with you. This is your covert narcissist again. A lot of times when you bring something up to the covert narcissist and they want something out of you, they will appease you. They'll say, oh, yeah, no, I'll take care of that, or I'll do that. and then they don't do it, okay? Maybe you tell them, oh, you know, can you work on the house here? This, oh, yeah, no, I'll take care of it, when they know that they're not going to do it, all right? And then later on, they gaslight you and they say, oh, I totally forgot about that. Oh, I didn't remember, or I was busy with something else, or, you know, I had something come up with my mother or something, all right? So they make fake promises and they fake agree to do things when they're not going to follow through. And that's the same thing as if you took a narcissist back that was hoovering you. They're going to make fake promises that things will be different. And they're going to try to put in your head that you never gave the relationship a chance. But they know that they're just going to be nice till they got you. And then they're going to go back to their old ways because that's what they like. That's what they know. They want to do what they want to do. They don't want to have to make you happy and do the work, all right? So they're great at pretending. Narcissists are great at pretending. They're great actors, great actresses, and this is what really causes that cognitive dissonance where people see the ugly, wicked narcissist at the end of the relationship and they say, I can't believe this is the same person. Well, it is, because you got tricked. You got tricked by a narcissist who, number one, was not all in, and number two, put on a fake mask to pretend that they were your ride or die, your hero, and in the end, they are your nightmare, okay? Now, so the basic things are, you guys, they flatter you, they give you attention, they give you, they give you a lot of their time. You're saying to yourself, oh, what, this person must really like me if they're giving me all their time. No, it's not that they really like you. It's that you have something that they want at the time, okay? They make promises. This is another way they trick you. They future fake you. They fake agree with you. And, you know, again, they mirror you. This is how they trick you, by mirroring you. They pretend, you know, they're just like you. And then the big one, you guys, is that narcissists pretend to like you when they really don't, all right? And a lot of times they do that for appearances. So you may be with the narcissist and be around other people, and they may pretend to other people that they're the nice guy, they're the good person, and you're the big bad wolf, okay? So how are they trick people into thinking they're the good person and you're the monster, okay? And they pretend to other people that they like you when in fact they don't like you. They pretend because they don't want to show their hand and show that they are villainous, that they don't like you. So they'll say things like, and again, this is the covert narcissist. They'll say things like, you know, I really tried with her. You know, I really did so much for her. You know, I did everything, and you know, she just doesn't appreciate, or she's crazy, you know, she has mental issues. This is how they trick other people. They pretend that they were in your corner when in fact they weren't. So they're worried about appearances. They're worried about what other people think, all right? What's another way that narcissists trick you? With that fake humility, okay? That's where they may humble themselves. Maybe they tell you a sob story and you're feeling bad, okay? This is more trickster of the narcissist. They're trying to show you that they're vulnerable when in fact they're not vulnerable in that sense, okay? They pretend to be vulnerable because then if they pretend to be vulnerable, you'll trust them, right? You figure, oh, they never told anybody that story. And I actually had a clown narcissist try this with me, okay? He actually tried to tell me a sob story. And then he goes and he says, oh, I never told anybody like that, that told anybody this story. It was calculated. It was somebody being a con artist. It was to trick me into thinking that I was special because he only told me that story. It was flat out game. It was flat out bullshit. And thank God I knew the game because I saw right through it and I saw what he was doing, okay? Why do they do that? To build your trust, okay? But see, narcissists, they're stupid. Some of them are really stupid because they don't study their target and they think everybody is stupid. And then they encounter somebody who is actually smarter than them and who actually plays them right back. And that's what happens to a lot of narcissists. They either run into a super empath or they run into another narcissist who's smarter than them and they get played, okay? And then they play the victim. That's the best. I've actually had clients that were narcissists that pretended that they were the victim, okay? Because they got played by another narcissist. Because I could tell by the things that they told me that they were narcissistic as well, but they got played by somebody who was more savvy, a more savvy, more clever narcissist. They got played. And you know what's hurting them? Their ego. And they're playing the victim, okay? It's ironic, I tell you. All right, so they fake humility. This is another way they trick you. And they are nice at times. Narcissists can be nice. They could be nice when they want something. And they could also be nice when they feel like being nice. And that's what throws you off. Because you say, oh, you know, I saw so-and-so, we had a get-together, and they were so warm, they were so kind, they were so nice. And meanwhile, what you don't realize is they're ripping you up behind your back and gossiping and smearing you, but you're getting fooled by the fakeness that they are showing you, okay? Again, predominantly, I'm talking about the covert narcissist here, all right? Because this is what they do. They don't show their hand. They show a complete different person of who they truly are to you and to other people. They hide their true authentic self within, all right? They're empty vessels. They're fractured souls. So that niceness at times is going to make you confused. And that's why you got to look at their pattern of behavior and their behaviors to really study it and say, no, 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 no. They were being nice to me because they wanted something. Oh, no, no, no. They were being nice to me because there were other people there and they were worried about appearances. They were worried about their image. See, you got to really dissect it. And then you'll say to yourself, nah, that niceness was not authentic. That was calculated, okay? So they're very calculated, all right? So what's another way that narcissists trick you? With excuses, all right? And this is another red flag that I tell people. Oh, you guys, let me just say this. When you're dealing with a real one, there you won't be dealing with a lot of excuses. You will know that they will follow through and that they are a straight shooter. But when you deal with a crooked narcissist, they're going to constantly come up with excuses to avoid accountability or avoid having to do things that they don't want to do. So they'll make excuses. Oh, I was sleeping. I didn't hear the phone ring. Oh, you know, I fell in the parking lot. Sorry, I didn't call you back. Oh, you know, the phone was in the other room or something like that. There's constant excuses. Or, oh, I'm sorry, I can't see you tonight. I totally forgot I had to work. Constant excuses. When you see it's constant excuses, you are dealing with a bullshitter and probably a narcissistic person that's trying to play you, okay? So that's how they trick you. And you sit there and say, you know, to other people, oh, they couldn't see me, you know, they had to work or something like that. When in fact, they're playing game on you. Now, the caveat to that is somebody might be telling you the truth, okay? They may have to work. So you're gonna have to really watch to see if it happens all the time. If they're constantly making excuses all the time, then you are most definitely dealing with somebody who is gaslighting you and playing games on you, okay? So another trick of the narcissist, And the biggest, one of the biggest tricks is gaslighting, okay? They love it. Gaslighting is just a way for them to confuse you so that they could dodge out of taking accountability, so they could put the blame on you, question your mental state, you know, oh, you're crazy or something like that, or I really think you need to talk to somebody. Hey, you didn't answer the question, but now you're telling me I need to talk to somebody. You are gaslighting me. Or when they say something like, I don't even remember what I did yesterday. Flat out lie. Of course they know what they did yesterday. You are being gaslit. They are playing mind games with you. And the way they play mind games is by the gaslighting, okay? The gaslighting. Now, my last point, and this is a big one. And this one, I hate to bring up politics, but I'm gonna do it, okay? The biggest way that narcissists try to trick you, one of the biggest ways is projection, okay? And what do? They project onto the other opponent exactly who they are, okay? So whatever they are, they're gonna call the other person. And they do this in politics all the time to get the shame off them, okay? So, you know, it's a matter of deflection. It's a way to get that shame off them and put the shame on the other person. I just did a post about this because I'm sitting here, I'm watching what's going on in today's politics, and I'm saying to myself, look at all of this projection that is going on. The person that is calling the other person, you know, ABC is actually ABC, okay? Or they're calling them toxic, they're calling them wrong, they're calling them, you know, the bad person, when in fact they are the bad person and trying to fool, manipulate, and brainwash people into thinking the other person is bad. It is projection, and it is a way to confuse people from seeing that they are the toxic person. And I'm going to leave it right there because I'm not going to get too political with you guys because I respect everybody's point of view, okay? But you need to think deeper. You need to see through these mind games that these narcissists play. And that is exactly what is going on today, okay? Some people see it and some people don't, okay? Some people are so, so gullible. Oh my goodness. And why are they gullible? Because they are closed-minded people. Period, dot, end of story. They are closed-minded people that only want to see what they want to see because it works to their benefit and it makes them feel good. So in a sense, they are narcissistic as well because they only want to see what they want to see because they feel it benefits them. So, you guys, woo, let's recap. Ways the narcissist tricks you. Flattery, love bombing, give you attention, keep you on the phone, give you their time in the beginning, make promises that they don't keep, future fake you thinking that they have a future with you. They fake agree with you. They pretend to like you. They show you fake humility. That's that sob story. Or they may put themselves down like the covert narcissist does, waiting for you to build them up. They are nice at times. This is how they trick you. They're nice at times. And they give excuses, which is basically, excuses are basically gaslighting, just so you know, all right? But you're thinking you could believe what comes out of the narcissist's mouth, and that's where you go wrong because you're believing their excuses without looking at the pattern of excuses and realize that this person is playing game on you, okay? Mirroring, another trickster move of the narcissist, you know, to fool you, all right? Projection, another way the narcissist tricks you, all right? So these are all the sneaky ways the narcissist and predominantly the covert narcissist. Remember, a narcissist could be covert and overt grandiose. They can. And I did a reel on this that I'm about to drop. And they can be both. But they use these tactics that I am describing to you today. So once you know the tactics, once you know the mind game, you are going to see, you're going to know the game. And once you know the game, you're going to be able to spot toxic and realize, hey, I'm dealing with somebody who's a toxic person who's trying to play mind games with me. I need to step back and know that I can't trust them and they're a liar, okay? And let's end it right here, you guys. I hope that helps you. Have a great day. If you're looking for confidential one-on-one phone coaching, you don't know if the person you're with is a narcissist, you don't know what kind of narcissist they are, you know, you're confused. Maybe it's about covert narcissists, which is pretty much what I specialize in, covert and malignant narcissists. Check out the link in the bio at askyaz.wixsite.com. If you're looking for more information, check out my YouTube at the Game Exposed podcast. Everything is on YouTube. Over 5,000 videos are on YouTube talking about all of this to help you understand. So check it out at the Game Exposed podcast on YouTube. For more posts and information, check out my Facebook, Instagram at the Game EXP 123, and TikTok is the Game Exposed. And have a great day, you guys, and don't let anybody pull the wool over your eyes or try to fool you, because now you're up on the game. Have a great day.